Hello, coffee drinkers. Yesterday was like the day I had no idea what to practice. It was kind of a drag. I kind of got there in the end. Today is the complete opposite. Been working super hard all day. Got my gym and tennis done early. I'm still on the jet lag a little bit, so I was up at 7, out on the courts, practicing, then training a little bit, and then really great to be in practice mode and to actually know what I want to practice. Was working on a ton of stuff for the core book, writing etudes, kind of going through the exercises and then making musical examples out of them so you guys can actually kind of immediately make music with these exercises. Very, very important that we make music out of the things we're working on in our kind of fundamental practice routine. Anyway, did a ton of that. But there was a question or a comment or something either yesterday or the day before talking about the looper and why do we always kind of default to going into 4-4 and why not 7 or some kind of other odd time signature. So why don't I do kind of an intro to playing in 7, something that doesn't get talked about so often. It's something I don't actually do that often. There's some stuff with Bob Reynolds that's kind of in 7, like here and there, and you know, it's not something I'm called upon to do so much anymore. But I did spend a very intense amount of time, a very intense period of live performance and practicing and hanging out and jamming, playing kind of a Balkan folk music, well, at least folk music based band, at least the rhythms came from there, called Sveti with Marko Djordjevic and various other musicians that came through that band, from Wayne Krantz to Ellie DeGibria. So many players were in that band, you know, through and through. So many bass players as well. I think Matt Garrison did it before me. I don't know who did it after me, maybe Peter Slater. Anyway, was a really fun band. I learned a lot about odd time signatures and how to kind of create claves. You know, I remember this one tune in 9. That was the bass line. And the bass line kind of ran throughout the song like that. That was kind of the clave. That was the anchor point. That is kind of how I hear some iterations of 9, even to this day. That one kind of mixolydian bass line. Anyway, on the subject of having some sort of clave or some sort of rhythmic, internalized rhythmic pattern when you play, 7 can be very, very easy like that if you break it up I break it up into da, 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 da. It's kind of two halves for me. I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. And what I'm doing with my hands, that's the clave. That's what I'm feeling internally. So instead of actually counting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, every time, I actually feel this kind of longer. So I'm kind of feeling downbeats rather than feeling every single subdivision of the bar or of the meter. So very important to be in control of that, understand where it's coming from in terms of the subdivision. In the first part you have 4 subdivisions, in the second part you have 3. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. That's actually a kind of a good challenge to set yourself to see if you can say 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3 while you're doing the clave at the same time. Let's try that a little bit slower. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. I don't think I've actually ever done that before. So there we go, coming up with one new exercise live on the vlog today. That's always a win. I was jamming a little bit before I switched the camera on. Same clave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's where the 7 is. Count to 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. So my goal initially when I get that clave, no matter what the meter is, no matter what the time signature is, 5, 3, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, doesn't matter. My initial aim is to be able to feel the bigger form, the bigger shape, and to actually be able to feel that downbeat. So what my goal is to get here. So that's all I'm really feeling. And if I play without that, and And I can really play around with the notes and like with the syncopation if I'm feeling that bigger, simpler picture. It's all about simplifying the bigger picture for me so I can get kind of detailed. Again, being in control of the subdivisions, but not necessarily counting them out all the time. And that's a process. You're gonna start counting them out. Then you're gonna restrict yourself to the clave. And then restrict yourself to just feeling the downbeat. Not restrict. Restrict is not the right word. Then progress to. Then be able to. Have the ability to. Start with the subdivisions, then go to the clave, and then go hopefully just to the downbeat. Really important to listen to some music that's in an odd time signature as well. Have melodies, have rhythmic patterns, have other types of claves that you identify other odd meter music with. There's the famous one. Boom, boom. In five, Sting, right? 7 days was all she... 7 days... I can't sing it, but whatever. You know the one from Ten Summoner's Tales, and it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. And whenever I hear that, that's kind of one major kind of landmark in learning how to play in five, was listening to that record a lot. There are words, there are melodies, there's a great groove from Vinnie Colaiuta, there's this very specific bass line. That was just one thing that I kind of attached to 5-4 now. Of course, it doesn't work for every iteration of 5-4, but it's a great place to start. It's something simple to understand. It is, at the end of the day, a pop song. There are words, there are so many things to anchor, so many anchor points in that, so many things to grab onto and use as a clave. So not only is it good to understand the concept of it and the subdivision and this is this and that is that, but it's good to listen to that music and really get a feel for it. And of course, if you can get together with friends, get together with other musicians and play that music, so much the better, especially if you're kind of, you know, all working on it at the same time and have a common goal to be more comfortable with an odd time signature. So back to having that groove in the looper, I've got a basic bass line in there, basic iteration of 7-4. Here's our clave going again. And see what I'm doing? You know, I know that I want to start soloing over this and explain to you kind of how I feel the beat, move here and there and land on beat two and all that stuff. But the first thing I do, pretty much always, no matter what I'm doing, the first thing I do is sit there and listen to it. I relax into it. I figure out where, you know, where the one is, where the tempo is. I really get adjusted and accustomed to what is going on, what I'm about to play over. So that's just a kind of a side note, but a very important point, a very important key to take into account. Really be relaxed, be inside the music. Don't rush into it. Just don't go running in there and be, take a step back. Just listen for a second or for 10 seconds. Let it go by 3 or 4 times before you jump into it. Now, in terms of playing over this groove and playing melodically, playing soloistically, improvising, you know, if I was new to 7, I might just set myself just using the clave. So, because we know if we play that rhythm, it's always going to end up on 1, and we'll never lose the beat. So maybe just play the root note. It doesn't sound that bad, actually. Very simple. And once you have that down, progress to maybe 2 notes. And every combination of those 2 notes you can possibly come up with. I think you see where I'm going here. I'm just using the clave and then adding a little more harmony, a little more melodic content as I go, as I become more comfortable with it. And it's a progression. It's not all going to happen right away. Some people are completely naturally gifted at doing that stuff. Some people grew up around folk music that contains that. For some people, like the Serbian guys and kind of former Yugoslavian guys I used to play with, that was definitely part of their culture. So that did actually come quite naturally to them. You know, you go to other countries and there'll be like 40,000 people in a football stadium all singing and dancing the chant in 7 or in 13 or something crazy like that. You go in the Balkans, in Bulgaria, in Serbia, in Montenegro, in Macedonia, all those kind of places. They have some really, really interesting music, some crazy odd metered music where it's just completely natural. As naturally as I hear 4/4, because, you know, I'm a white dude from England who grew up around rock and roll and pop and R&B, like 4/4, that's, I guess that's my heritage for what it's worth. At least that's what I grew up listening to as a kid. They feel like that odd meter music just as easily as I feel like, Michael Jackson or something. Just as easy as I feel 4 in a bar, they feel 13 in a bar. So everyone is on a slightly different level here, and people are coming from different backgrounds. But take it slowly. It is a progression. It will take some time if you're not used to this, if you're brand new to this right now. So other suggestions I would have, you know, like that's a good starting point. I did some stuff, I did a bunch of stuff on VBL about playing in odd time signatures, not just 7, but 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, all the odd numbers up to 15. And so there's some more, way more in-depth stuff. This is just kind of what was floating around my head today, something I hadn't done in a while. And what with that comment that came up yesterday on the vlog, I thought it was perfect to give kind of an intro to that. Some variations in terms of getting more in control of your melodic playing or your groove playing, just the subdivisions within 7. I like to try and find all the other beats in the bar, not necessarily landing on the downbeat every time. So maybe I want to look for the 2. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2. So maybe that becomes my stronger, that becomes my strong beat of the bar just as an exercise. I'll do that with every beat in the bar, not just the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, but the 1 and 2 and 3. And I've worked on that a lot. So really working on the subdivisions in depth. That's just the, you know, maybe the first and easiest example besides the downbeat. And you know, you can use the clave, adjust the clave to work the 2 in there. So we go bum, bums, 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 oh, bum, bums, 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 oh, bum, bums, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3. So how would that be? 1, 2, bums. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Yeah, so you just shift the clave from hitting the downbeat to beat 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1, etc., etc. And then shift it all over the place, the and of 1, the and of 2, the and of 3. You can really get creative with it. That, you can do that on your own time. I don't need to take 40 minutes of your time on the vlog doing that. But it's a lot easier than perhaps it sounds when you have the basic tools and the framework and a little bit more of an understanding about how the rhythm works. And then go in search of weird sevens. I think in Israel, of all places, they actually do 3, 4. Rather than 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, they go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I think. It's been a long time since I've talked to anyone about it or played any of that music, but if I'm not wrong, maybe I'm wrong. If anyone knows that, leave me some comments. I would like to relearn that, if that's a fact or if that's a myth. I don't know, but I'm pretty sure. Anyway, doesn't matter how they do it. People all around the world, they have different claves, they have different approaches to it. The 4-3, just kind of the easiest one for my ear anyway, to get your foot in the door and to start working on this stuff and feel comfortable. And like I said, feeling the bigger picture. Start off with the subdivision, understand where each of the points of that clave fall, and then start to feel the bigger picture. Just maybe a big 1. Maybe that's the next step. So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. So you're feeling every subdivision. Then you move to the clave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then maybe you take out the second beat of the clave to just have a big 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. So you've got less things to hold on to. There are only 3 things in that clave there. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 1. And then maybe you take out the third element of the clave, that downbeat of the 3 section. so many things you can do with it. These are just things I'm coming up with off the top of my head, not things I've necessarily practiced that much before. But definitely that feels like a good path, a good kind of route to take when you're getting into this. Anyway, I'm gonna work on this stuff now. I'm done with chords and etudes for the day. This is actually super fun. I am gonna have to play a little seven with Bob coming up in a few days' time. So kind of perfect timing to get that back into my playing and feel a little more comfortable with it. Today's vlog is done, and we'll see you guys tomorrow.